President-elect Trump, which sounds weird every time I say it, spoke about the issue of gay marriage, and he took an interesting new path.
One of the groups that's expressing fear is the LGBTQ group.
I mentioned them at the Republican National Convention. And
you did.
Everybody said, that was so great. I have been, you know, I've been a supporter.
Well, I guess the issue for them is marriage equality. Do you support marriage equality?
It's irrelevant because it was already settled. It's law. It was settled in the Supreme Court. I mean, it's done.
So even if you appoint a judge that...
It's done. You have... these cases have gone to the Supreme Court. They've been settled. And I think I'm fine with that.
Interesting. So I have a lot to say on that. First of all, good. Credit where credit is due. That's a much better answer than Rick Santorum would give, or Mike Huckabee would give, or Ted Cruz would give, or any of the really big-time social conservatives would give. So there's a massive upside in that. The second thing is, you know he's personally fine with gay marriage, because when he's asked about Roe versus Wade and whether or not that needs to be repealed, he says, yes. Okay, but hold on, Don. That's a settled case, too. So notice the logic isn't the same. For gay marriage, he basically uses the logic, look, it's settled law. They had the case, they came to their conclusion, let's move along here. Well, that same reasoning would be applied to Roe versus Wade and abortion. But you didn't do that. With abortion, you said, well, no, that should be looked at, and I'm going to appoint pro-life judges. And he even went on to say in the interview, a woman might have to go to another state to get an abortion. So on one of them, he's like, well, it's already settled law. And the other one, even though it's settled law, he's like, no, we're going to change that one. So that shows you, on some level, personally, he's like, yeah, whatever, I'm fine with gay marriage. Which isn't surprising. But, so credit where credit is due, but the third point, and perhaps the most important point, is that might all be irrelevant, because the real issue is, who will you appoint to the Supreme Court? Because that's all it comes down to. If there's another gay marriage case that gets in front of the Supreme Court, who did you appoint? Did you appoint somebody who is going to be pro-gay marriage or against gay marriage? Did you appoint somebody who... And by the way, you could forget, you could throw out the window the idea of new anti-discrimination laws for the LGBT community. So they're not a protected class right now. There are some classes that are protected classes. You go back to the Civil Rights Act, you find out that, you know, African Americans, okay, you're a protected class. But gays are not in that. So there's anti-discrimination laws against blacks, for blacks, I should say, for example. So you cannot discriminate. You can't say, I'm not going to hire you because you're black. That would be against the law, as it should be. But for gays, you can still, in over 20 states, say, I'm not going to hire you because you're gay. Or get out of my restaurant, you're gay, and I'm not comfortable with that. So if you could forget the, you know, Trump expanding anti-discrimination laws. That's not going to happen. But what he's saying is, look, I personally am not going to roll it back. But who are you going to appoint to the Supreme Court? Because he said before, I'm going to appoint the next Antonin Scalia to the Supreme Court. Well, if you appoint the next Antonin Scalia, a justice in the mold of Antonin Scalia, well, then it doesn't matter what you think about it, Don, because that person, if a gay marriage case comes in front of him, will say, yeah, I'm going to get rid of gay marriage. I'm going to vote against gay marriage. And it looks like we're going to have a massively conservative Supreme Court, as far as the eye can see, because a bunch of them are super old, and there's already one empty seat, and now President Trump gets to fucking fill it. So, by the way, the Republican obstruction worked. They said, we're going to break a record and, not appoint somebody to the court for the remainder of Obama's term. This happened so long ago when Scalia died. And they did it that entire time, and the Democrats didn't make a stink about it, didn't argue much. They just sat there, I guess we're being obstructed. Fucking argue, you dumb pricks! You idiots! You can win on that issue alone, but of course the Democrats never fight, and they ended up losing on it. So, that's the bottom line here. He's personally fine with gay marriage, and I give him credit for that. But if he appoints a Scalia-like justice, it doesn't matter if you're personally fine with it, because they'll fight back against gay marriage when on the court. So, good to hear you say that, Don, but appoint a fucking liberal justice. And then we're really, really, really beginning to have a discussion here about what your values are when it comes to social issues.